Yeah, good morning, one and all. I hope my audio is now audible, I guess. I could see a lot of charts since I knew that it's only a few days left for the midterm exam. Do not worry, today we'll have that discussion once we finish the recap of the heat sort, and then I'll open some duration for the midterm discussion, and then I'll focus on a topic which is not part of the midterm. So do not worry, just hold your questions, because there are a lot of questions which actually are creating confusion for the student himself, because he is worried about certain sorting algorithms which were not discussed. So do not worry, I will be giving you a clear picture on it. But first of all, I would like to know whether I am audible to you clearly or not, so that I can start today's session. Yeah, okay, great. So basically, okay, I think the audio is good for most of the people. Yeah, so don't worry. So first focus is on the midterm, then and then see, Ram, basically that's what I told you. I'm requesting you people, please hold your questions for the first 20 minutes, so that let me finish the heat sort, because last time people understood it, but I felt they missed some approach of thinking, so that it is creating them confusion. Right, so I thought I'll clear that first today's session, because the way I wrote the algorithm was not appropriate. It was a correct algorithm, but it was little confusing. So I thought it's better I modify the PPT and then describe the heat sort once again, and once it's clear, we are done with the midterm syllabus. Then we'll have some time where I'll be discussing little bit of whatever your questions are there regarding midterm, and then I will go to a non-midterm topic, that is introduction to sorting algorithm. No, do not worry, every kind of questions that you will ask, I will be answering, don't worry. Okay, right. So regarding the sample question paper standards, these that things, you might have certain concerns, so let me answer them at the time of Q&A once we finish the heat sort. Right, so first I'll discuss about the heat sort, then I'll, then you can ask questions about heat sort. Once you are comfortable, then we will open the Q&A form for the midterm related. Once both are done, then we will go to the next topic. So do not worry, I am not going to put constraints on you regarding asking the questions, right? But I will request one after the other question, I will be happy to answer, right? Good. Let me again start with the greet. That's good morning. And before going to this session, wish you all the best for your upcoming midterm exam. And so today, we will be focusing on the topic of midterm exam, which is heat. So right, now people will be worrying, which we discussed in the last session, why we are recap. Since in the last session, we had a major, even I felt that there is a need of recap of heat sort to be done in a way such that it is understood more clearly and detailed, right? That's the reason why we are doing a heat sort recap. Okay. Now, in the last session, when I was teaching heat sort, we introduced something called the reason of learning. Before we learned about heat sort, we have been introduced two more new topics, something called as heapification, and then we were introduced something called as belt heap, right? And then later we did the heat sort. So to understand heat sort, we should understand two properties called as heapification, and then we should understand something called as a belt heap. Before this, I would like to say heap is a kind of data structure which comes with a particularly with something called a shape property. Okay, the shape property that we the shape property of heap. The shape property of heap is it should be a complete binary tree, right? Which complete binary tree, right? That, and I think everyone knows the definition of a complete binary tree. And always remember, height of a complete binary tree is order of log n. Okay. So we should first understand heapification. Once we are clear with heapification, I'll go with the belt heap, then I'll go with the concept of heap sort, right? So I might appear a little skipping of certain slides. The slides remain the same. Only difference is I just wrote updated PPTs. The reason why I have written updated PPTs is I have modified the pseudocode for your understandability. Okay. The height of a complete binary tree is always order of log n. Okay. Okay. Right. So let me start with the shape property. I think you all know that it is shape property is a complete binary tree. Apart from shape property, the heap property says that the node value or the root value either should be greater than its chain nodes, be the left chain or the right chain, okay, or vice versa. That is the root node value, the node parent value should be greater than its left chain or right chain. Okay, yeah, the answer is log n. The height is log n. I told that. If accidentally I told n log n, I'm sorry, it's log n, right? Don't worry. Okay, so right, let me go quickly to the and if the parent node is is greater and it is throughout the heap, then we call it as max heap. If it is minimal and it is representing throughout the heap, we call it as a min heap, right? Okay, that's the simple property of heap. Okay, and I have already discussed the time complexity is order of the time complexity in the heap sort is order of n log n. So today we will see other sorting algorithms where the time complexity is order of n square. After the midterm, we will start the sortings, that is merge sort and quick sort, where the time complexity is order of n log n. So right, and we will see why we prefer heap sort than the quick sort when we understand quick sort and the drawbacks of quick sort. Right? Okay. This this representation. I think how to identify. Very good question. Now since we'll start from here. Okay. Now since a lot of people have learned binary search tree, they are actually getting little ambiguous at the time when they look at tree structure. See, you have learned totally three kinds of tree. One, they started with simply called as binary tree, then they learned about binary search tree, later they advanced this binary search tree to AVL tree to avoid the order of n search time, right? So something we have learned. Now the question is a heap sort, when I'm talking about tree, out of which category does this tree belongs to? The tree belongs to the category of binary tree only. What does it mean? What does the category of binary tree mean? Let's have a look here. Now when I say a binary tree, so I'm just talking in terms of binary tree with to be a complete binary. And full binary tree is the one in which all the levels of the node should be filled. In a complete binary tree, the left with all the levels except the leaf nodes can start filling from the leftmost element is a complete binary tree. Okay? Sometimes people say almost complete binary tree. So what I'm talking about, heap should be a binary tree and that to be a complete binary tree. Let's look at here. When you look one. Sorry, I think I have pressured it more. So let me go back one slide and come. So that, okay. Right. Just one second. So this is the issue. Okay, here I would like to just draw the heaps or the binary tree and then we'll just go. Just give me a second. Let me finish it in a normal flow. Okay. So let's say, when you look at this shape, this is a binary tree as well as a complete and as well as a full. But when this tree comes up, this becomes a complete binary tree, right? And apart from this one more tree, I can say this as also a complete binary tree. Okay. Now the question is, in binary search tree, we always have a condition that the left chain value should be smaller than the root and the right chain value should be greater. Here we are not imposing that condition. What the condition we are imposing is, let's say if I have a tree with three chains, let's say 3, 5 and 4. Now the shape is, just look at this. This is a binary search tree. It's a binary tree. But can I call this as binary search tree? No. But I can call this as a min heap tree because the root node is smaller than its left and right chain. That's the ordering is not at all important, but that's the only constraint we have in the shape property being binary plus complete. So no order, nothing. So for someone else, you can have a tree 7 and 6. This is fine. This also I can say, but this is also a this also a heap, right? Okay, but preferably if there are possibly we try to be it as a complete, right? And this is a complete. Now this, I hope this is clear. Now the question is, let's first understand heapification, then we will move to heap. Now in the given diagram, when you are looking for this following diagram, what is happening is the property of heap should be throughout should be throughout the tree. Now I think here I am satisfying the max heap property. Yes. Do I am satisfying max heap property here? So if you look at my whole bind tree, my left subtree and my some accidentally my right subtree are satisfying the heap property. But the heap property I am missing. But missing is at the root, right? I am missing this at the root. So I think some people have audio issues. Let me once stop the recording and restart the recording here. Just give me one second. Okay, now I did that. So when you look, somehow we have accidentally assumed that there can be trees where heap satisfaction might not have satisfied internally. Do not worry. So first we will try to understand heapification, then we will see how to do this heapification recursively so that none of the sub left or right subtree are avoided. Okay? Assume somehow we reached at this state, or when we were designing a binary, designing the tree, accidentally we got something like this. Now what will be your solution to make this as a heap? What you will do to make this heap, two should be in its appropriate position. So you will say, let's compare two with its left chain or its right chain, whichever is greater, just swap it. So I'm just talking orally. Let's look in the next minute with the pseudocode. So what I say, okay, so I'll just say it's better for me to swap two with the largest value in its one of the chain. See, I'm not actually solving the problem globally, I'm solving locally. I'm only worried between 2, 14 and 8. Just I want, and throughout our discussion we'll be talking about max heap only. So you can do the minor changes and you can do the min heap. Okay, so we have done the change. So people would say it's better for me to do the swap between 2 to 14. Yes, the moment I do to 14, technically the subtree, left subtree is getting affected, right? I will get the left subtree affected. This 14 will be replaced with 2, the 2 will be replaced with 14 at root. Only root and the right tree is satisfied, but the left tree got affected. Now what you say, can I do this recursively? Yes, you can do recursively. Then you will change 2 and 12, and 12 will go to the position of 2, and 2 will have the 12 will have the 2 in its position. Then this subtree is valid, but at this point we might miss. So repeat this, and finally the 2 goes to its position. The process, this recursive process, or the first step what you did is also called as a heapification. But after doing the swapping between 2 and 14, you did the same method recursively between the next level. Okay, I should use the level 1, level 0, level 1, level 2. Okay, you did recursively again the same process at level 1 and at level 2, right? Let's see how I am going to do this process with graphical representation, right? Okay, and trying to understand the pseudocode. Okay, do you want me to show how come Poonami it's not a complete binary tree? So I have a very valid question. If I think these kind of questions can be there in someone's mind, I would like to read them out. Since I should not read the name, but I'm sorry, right? How is, do anyone think this is not a complete binary tree, the example which we discussed, right? Yeah, heap sort we don't need to discuss about BST at all, but that's the question that continues with a lot of people, so I thought it's better for me to discuss. Yeah, it's a complete binary. If at all people are getting confused, this could be the reason for them to misunderstand. See, here it's leftmost. If this tree was rightmost filled, then you would have said it is not, it would have been not a complete. See, at the leaf node, from left only our filling is started, right?
Okay.
Okay. So this what okay, there is a question regarding difference between full and complete. I'll discuss once I'm done with this here. Okay? I'll just show with a diagram. Okay? Yeah, don't worry. I understand your concerns. I'll do that. Okay? Do not worry, but please do remind the same question at the time of Q&A, right? With on AV, on the keys. Right. Okay. Good. So just give me 15 more minutes. I will be ensuring you that. You will understand the heat shot very clearly and you will get the basic clarities, right? Okay. Now what I did, I'm just showing you the graphical. Now if you see, the swap had happened, right? Okay, and this also I did in the next step, that is swapping between 2 and 12, then I continued between 11 and 12. This was what I have done, this was done throughout the process, okay? Right. Now let's look at how we are doing heapification in the form of an algorithm. So first of all, let me have a diagram next to it. Before that, I would like to... Okay, that's a very good question. Okay. So in my... Okay, there is one question between one of your friends. He had a particular question stating, why we have not served between 8 and 2? If I'm wrong, please do correct. Now the question is, in heapification process, the swap happens only between the element that is larger, okay? So unfortunately, the largest element out of two, but out of the child for two, that is either 14 or 8. The largest is 14, that's why the swap happened. We are not talking about order of swap. So if you have a question, let's say, sir, we are not saying swap right first, then left. It's nothing. Whichever value is greatest of the chain to the parent will be swapped. For that, we have to do a comparison that I am showing in the algorithm. How do I decide to convert between my... See, that is the question it comes here. See, they ask you to... See, technically, most of the heat sorts are... Maxis. The reason why is Maxis is used in priority queues, so that's the reason most of the heats are actually Maxis. But if someone wants you to convert a minion, they definitely mention please do convert a minion. You can write only pseudocode. Okay. In this session, heapify means it's always Maxis, but heapification is a process of changing the nodes in its appropriate position. Okay, so people are more concerned about exams than learning today's concept here. I'm sorry to say that. See, I told you I will honor all your discussions, but you're not allowing me to finish my the session. Right? Please, I'll spend more time in answering your questions. Okay, let me allow finish this. Okay? Right. No, there are two. Okay, fine. So let me please do finish. The chat box keep on distracting me, so even I hided it. Okay, let me just give me 15 minutes as a request. Let me finish the things I will move it. Right. Okay. Now one of your friends has a very valid question. How did you decide between swapping 14 or 8? This is a very valid question, but that was not a wrong question. Okay. So now the question raised, let's say how I have done. Let's also have the diagram existing, right? This was what we were supposed to be using. The heapification was the process of changing the position of 2 to 14 because I was working on max, right? Now, as one of your friend has mentioned, I should not swap between 2 to 8. Actually, technically, that actually makes little valid question. So see how the logic or the algorithms take the decision 14 should be selected. Now first one. Now remember, a heap sort is done on a node which has got its child nodes. Remember, Now, before going to this word, we will just talk about a small story or a small situation. Which notes can we call as deep notes with the deep one? Okay. Now, let's see. You are alone in the exam hall, and if you write exam and you score 20, can I call you as the first rank in the class? Can I call you the first rank in the class? Right. Why can I call you in the first rank in the class? Why should I call you first? You are alone. It means a single note, not competition. A single note is a note always, you can say it as a heap note. Can I use this word? If there are no children, the note itself is called as a heap note. Can I use that word? Yeah, you agree. So, according to your understanding, list out the notes that you would mark them as heap notes. Mark the notes that are heap, just heap. Which all notes would you feel to be heap notes? All the leaf notes, right? All the leaf notes. Can I say that word? Can I say that word? Can I say the word that according to you, all the leaf notes are heapified or are already heaped? Yes, as per your understanding, I think, yeah, all the leaf notes are heapified. Correct. Now the question raises this. If a node is heaped, do I have to do heapification on it? The first question raises is that. If a node is heapified, no, right. Now, if you are doing a heapification on a particular node, what is the makes you to decide that heapification has to be done? No, see, I'm just saying all leaf nodes are heapified. Because there is no computation, it doesn't have any change, so there is no comparison. You are the heapified, which means either you are max heap or min heap. That's what we are trying to. Now my question is, how would you decide a heapification should be done? Should be done. Few of you have answered me that if a node has children, yes, if node should have children, right? If a node has children, then I decide to do a heapification or to check whether the heap property holds or not, right? So just understand that. Now, the first step what we are trying to do is on any node on which you have to do heapification, it should have a left chain and a right chain, or one of the chains it should have. Now, in this case, which is the node that we decided heapification to be done? Which is the node that we have decided heapification is? Just say the node 2, okay? It's just node 2. Now, what you are doing in the heapification is you are trying to identify the left chain of the node 2 and the right chain of node 2. Here, how do you identify? Can anyone help me? How is the identification of a node? How can you identify a left chain of a node and a right chain of a node? Can I say 2i plus 1? Okay. Can I say 2i for left and can I say 2i plus 1 for right? Let me write that. Here I am using the formula 2i plus 1. Sorry, do I use 2i or 2i plus 1? If it depends on the starting of array. If my array starts with 0, it is 2 of I plus 1. But for your understanding, I say my array is starting from A of 1. Okay? So my array starts at A of 1, so the formula is 2 of I. What will be the formula to identify my right chain? It is 2 of I plus 1. Okay? Yes, got it. That's the logic I have used here to identify the left chain and the right chain. So my left chain, I is the node 2. Just give me a second here, I'll go back because this WebEx has some issue. For the clear. Okay, the node on which you wanted to do heapification is your ith node. Okay, so you are doing your ith, first time when you do the heapification on any node, that will be your I node. So here my I node is 2. Now I have found its left chain and I have found its right chain. Now what should I do? Now I should See whether the left chain, okay, before comparison, yes, one is comparison, very good. For comparison, I am saying, is the left greater than the root node or not? E of I is here the root node, which is our second one, okay? Then, apart from that, I am doing one more comparison. Is the left chain what do you mean to say? Is less than or equal to the heat size? What is it? What is the heat size here according to you? What is the heat size according to you here? The total number of nodes involved in the heap are called as heat size. How many nodes do we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So total nodes I have this one. And what is this node position? What is this node position currently according to you? What is this node position? It's 2. So it is less than the total number of nodes. It's less than the total number of nodes. And yes, so it's less than. The left, whatever you have, is less. It's not about 14 comparing between. The position of 14 according to array is 2. So 2 is less than the position comparison of 12, that is heap size. Heap size is none other than the total number of nodes stored in the array. Okay, for this also there is something called array length will also work here, right? Don't worry. So you are trying, if these two conditions are there, we will go. Now why I am checking for this condition is to avoid. Divya, we will discuss if my pseudocode is wrong just after few minutes. Okay, so don't worry, my pseudocode is correct, but I might have written in an unconvincing way. That is a different story altogether. Right? So you are trying to compare the value of this. The heap size is the total number of nodes that the heap has. That is how many nodes it is storing in the array heap size. Okay. Once your comparison is done, between the left and right. Yes, we'll talk here. Just give me a second. Once the comparison is done between 2 and 14, what is the largest number currently? It's 14. That's the left chain. So here if you see, I have assigned 14. After this, do I go to this else loop? So I have found out that there is a value that is greater than the root, and that is larger, that is currently labeled as largest value. Now the question raises, actually 8 is greater than 2. The question raises 8 is also greater than. If I would have compiled right first, what would be the greatest value? What would have been the greatest value? If right was done first, 8. Now why we start with left? Anyone can give me the answer? Why we started with left? It's not less number. In a complete binary tree, the filling at the leaf node will happen from the leftmost node. No, it's not 14 greater than 8. Remember, okay, I'm talking about the algorithm. Why my step first? It's not even about travel, sir. Understand the question, please. I'm trying to say, instead of comparing left, I can do right comparison. Is it a valid comparison or not? Yes, it would have been. But why we start from left is, in a complete binary tree, in a leaf node, the filling always, if you have a leaf node, its chain will always be the left chain first, then right chain. Yes, left, from left you go to the right. That's the reason why we compare left. Now, there can be a question. There could have been a question here. One second. There could have been a question, let's say this is 14, if it was 15, even then what value I am giving here as largest, it's still 14 because 15. Now to avoid this kind, I will also check, do I have a right chain and what is the value of the right. Now let's look at the logic for this for him. You understand now why left I checked and then now how I am checking the right. Now if someone says, let's compare I with the right. Let's say compare I with the right. What will be the wrong that you get over here? What wrong can happen? If you compare the root node with right, which value becomes the largest now? 8. Good. In the previous case, what was the largest value? When you compare with your left child, what was the largest value? 14. Now, which one should get replaced is a big challenge, right? It's a big ambiguity. When we are writing a pseudocode, these kind of minor things we have to take care. Let's see what was the minor thing, how we will try to. Now, this is the largest value according to this out of these three. Now, at this, before going to write compare, you realize that the largest value is 14. Now, what I will do is, if 14 is great, if 8, if the right child is greater than 14, I should swap. If not, there is no need. Right? Is this my condition? If right child is greater than the left, then only I have to swap. Otherwise, no. So what we do is, what we do is, look at right. I see, I identify there exists a heap size. Good. Then, I'm comparing the right child with the greatest value, not anymore with the root here. Not anymore with the root. You see, I'm not comparing 8 to 2. I'm comparing between 14 and 8. This is what the logic has written. Okay? Got that at this point? You have understood why it is A of last already, because you updated the value of I to be last. No more. Okay. Why else here, right? If, let's say this is 1. If this is 1 instead of 14. Do you do any updation? Which one would have been greater? So I would have been else, right? So I just think. Yeah, it's an if-else statement, yeah? So just done. The next is another if statement, okay? So we have done with this. Now, which value is replacing? Which value is replacing? If you see, since right is not, we are replacing. Okay. Till here, everyone is clear? Till this point, I guess. Okay, now let's see. Now do I update right to the largest? Yes or no? Do I update right to largest? Do I update right to largest? Right to largest. 8 is largest value. This RI is the, currently it's 8. Is 8 largest? Not in this case. Correct. You are not updating RI to largest anymore. So currently what is the largest we have, which is 14. I is being updated. I to be largest, which is none other than, sorry, not here. Largest is equal to 14. You are done. So now what you do, you exchange between the largest and 14. After you run the step, what is going to happen is this happened? Till now, is this happened? Just look at till the step. You are only till the step. Is this what it happened? Just give me a second here, I'll explain you size of the heap for a minute. So did you understand this swap has happened? Okay. Now people have a big concern about why do I have to consider the size of the heap, right? Now what happens in the data structure is, it's a very realistic question. It's not an unvalued question why people are asking about heap size. It's actually a valid question. Just give me a second, I'll explain. Now when you have an array, what is array? It's a fixed amount of memory size that you are given. Now let's say 3. It's a node. Do you say this is a node? Do you agree 3 to be a node? Yes. What are the 3's left and right chain? Can anyone say what are the 3's left and right chain? You are saying they are not existing. There are no chain. In realistic world or in the computer world, this 3's left chain will be pointed to null and 3's right chain will be pointed to null, right? So you are actually pointing the 3's value to something called null. To unnecessarily go and compare with null, what happens is if you do not compare the heap size with the size of the element, you are actually going into an infinite loop. You understand? Now basically this 3 will be pointing to null and it will be pointing to null memory. If I'm going and unnecessarily stuffing in null memory, I'm wasting time. To just avoid this null situation, what we say, I am only interested my comparisons if the total size of heap is less than or equal to. Within 12 nodes only I want. So the moment you are coming to this 12, it doesn't have left chain. So this 12 is like, okay, fine, left chain. After that, I don't go. Right? That's the reason why we try to go for the heap size. Got that? Unnecessary to avoid to go into this waste memory, or what you can say unused memory. We just try to see the heap size. I hope I'm clear up there now why we are using heap size. Yes, unwanted comparison, sometimes you might end up into, just to avoid, so that I just want my performance to happen within the given size. Okay. Now, heap size is a function. You can, this heap size is a direct function called a dot heap size, you call in your Java programming or if not, length of array. Okay, length of array also can be used instead of heap size. These are predefined functions. Whenever you are using the hidden libraries of array, these functions are there. Okay. Now I'm just going to finish this. After moving here, actually this particular subtree has become, if you see, this particular subtree has become is not holding heap. So that's the reason why I'm calling again heapify. So this is where the heapify recursively happens. Right? Now let's go. Just we'll try to finish this example and okay. Now someone wanted me question to the right one. Can I go to the right one? Can I go to this right one here? Instead of right at 8, is this also okay? No? This is also right 12. 12 is also okay, right? So your right portion will be compact. Can I do that, or do you want me to have an example of 15 value only? Okay, so let's start this. Yeah, so let's look at this process. So if you look this particular, don't worry, else part I'll explain. Just give me a second. Okay, I'll explain you else part here. Great, don't worry. See, I've not kept the bracket here. In Sudoku, we don't keep too many brackets. Okay, then it becomes a program. That's where people are getting missing a lot of things. Okay, now can I consider this as one tree? For the right example, can I consider this as one tree? Can I consider this? Okay. Just forget, ignore there is a tree existing. Just ignore a tree that exists. So assume we are working on this particular 212 and this tree. Right? Now what happens is, let's see. Heapify, now I value is 2. Can you say I value is 2 here? Yeah. Now you have left, do I have left child? Do I have right child? We are done. 10 and 12 are the new values we have checked. Now do the compare. Do I have to do swap between left and right? Do I have to do 10 and 2? Is there any swap? No. Why? Because the left is not, is, sorry. One second. Just give me a second. I just went with this example. 1 second. Yeah, here it is. 10 and 2 swap is required, right? You told not. It's required because 10 is greater than 2. Yes? 10 is greater. So the largest value here becomes as your left. Now hold on. Now do I am doing swapping here, or we are going to right comparison? I should do right. If I do swap, what will happen? 10 will take over 2 and 2 will come to 10's position. Look at it. See, I just updated my largest value to the 10. I updated my largest value to 10. Next, I am not going to run this else loop. See. Because this comparison, there is a value, so no need of comparison. Then if you go to if, you are just comparing between your right value to the largest value. That is 10 to 12 comparison is happening. The A of R is 12. Okay, let me write here. Currently this is 12. Largest value is 10. Why? Because here you have assigned 10 to be the largest value, right? Then you compare. Which one is largest according to you? Which one is largest according to you after this comparison? Yes. So you have assigned the largest value 12 again. So now you are going to exchange between. So the I is no more largest. So you are going to exchange. Is this okay? So your right comparison is done. Yeah. Swap node done. Correct. Got it? Okay. So this is the way how your heapification is done. And if you see in a heapification, if you see the heapification is only done on one side of the tree. If you are doing half of the elements, then your time complexity is order of log n. So you can see order of log n is your time complexity. Right? Now let's move to do. But now people will have a question. If, one second here. I'm sorry at this, I think the my writing pad is also creating me some trouble, so let me disconnect that. Any responses is so slow. Okay, one second. Yeah, okay. So you did, when you did the heapification, if you have observed heapification, you are actually doing on one side of the tree. And if there are other side of the tree, there are heapification to be done. We might be missing this piece, right? We are missing. Right? Now, how to overcome this issue? Now, the first question is, in a heap, to overcome this, we'll be using a concept called built heap. Okay, we'll be using a concept called built heap, which also takes care of ensuring that the binary tree is in the heap property along with the heapification, and which is done from bottom to top approach, right? Let's see how we are doing. According to the given values, is this a binary tree that you are going to construct? Is that correct or wrong? According to the given values, is this a binary tree that can you construct? Yes. Okay. Before working on this PPT, let me show you the built heap pseudocode and we will just come back to this slide. Okay. Don't worry with these animations, I just want it. Okay. This was the tree what you constructed. Now when you learn heapification, actually you started from top, right? You see, you did the heapification at root node, yes or no, when we were learning that. Yeah. Just apply that algorithm here. In which direction my heapification will move? Just heapification. In which direction will it move, on the left subchain or the right subchain? It will move on the right subchain. And what will be my value that I will be taking to the top? What will be the value? 3. Okay. After that, it will be 7. Right? It will. My root node will be 3. I will have 7 and 11. Is then the tree, will you call it as a max heap? Will you call this as a max heap? No. Now the most important thing is, if this approach, okay, accidentally this became somehow, let's say accidentally, which part of the tree will be max heap if you still do from the top? Heapification, which part of the tree? I think the right subchain will be heapified. If you do heapification from top, from this to this, only this particular will be at the correct, and rest all the tree will be not in the max heap. Correct? Do you agree with that term or no? Yeah. Now the question rises over here is, if I'm doing from top down approach, I'm not at all able to make the tree to be heapified. Right? No, you cannot have combination of min heap on the left subtree and max heap on the right subtree. Your whole tree should be either min heap or max heap. To overcome this, if I start heapification from bottom up for all the levels, that is from level 0, level 1, level 2, level 3, all the elements at level 3, all the elements at level 2, all the elements at level 1, then go to level 0, will I be able to do heapification? If I start from bottom up, yeah, great. So if you see, when you are doing heapification between any two elements, just look at these two. In which order is the heapification done? The root node to the chain node comparison, right? Root node to the chain node comparison. This is what it is happening. When heapification is done, the parent node to the chain node comparison is happening. Okay. To take care of this, the build heap comes into picture. Because I have to travel from bottom to top, going through all the nodes to ensure that the heapification is done. What built heap does is, look at it. See, I want to know the heap size because I want to do heapification on only the number of elements in my tree, right? Yes or no? See, do you want to do a heapification process on the nodes that are not part of your tree? I think no. So I just find what is the length of the tree. Here, finding the length of the heapification, length of the array is needed to for other condition, that is. Okay, now I have few questions. Do I need to do heapification on 6, 7, 10, 9, 8? First answer this question. Do I have to do heapification on 8, 9, 10, 6, 7? Why? Why you are saying heapification is not required? Because they are leaf nodes. Great. Cool. Now from where do you think heapification has to be done? From 5. Just hold 5. If I run heapification at 10, let's assume, will the heapifying algorithm will work? If I run on 10, will the heapification, no, okay. From where the heapification algorithm will start running correctly? If the node has a chain, yes or no? If the node has a chain. Now I am only interested in identifying, see I am running from bottom to top, identifying that a chain, a node which has got a chain. How do I identify that is? Length of A gives what? The length of A gives me the total number of nodes that are present. How many nodes are present here? Can anyone say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10? Now, 10 by 2. If I do 10 by 2, what is the answer I am getting? The 5. What 5 is not? See, technically here 5, assume that. One second. Assume 5 here as something that is also value and the array position. Is this array position you are getting? Yes, indexed value. Array position, indexed value. From 5, if you go all the way till index position 1, every node will have chain node. Yes or no? Just look. Every node will have a chain node. Yes or no? If you travel from node 5, node 4, node 3, node 2, node 1. Every node will have, it's not a combination without, because that's the property of the complete binary tree. Now, on these nodes, if I implement heapification, that is enough. If I do only heapification, that's enough or not? Yes, okay. Now, I have a very good question from one of your friends that's literally needed, so I'll just do. Why heapification is not happening from left subtree when it is a complete binary tree? This is a very valid question. Now, what I just did till now is I am identifying from where heapification should be done. Now, say me from where the heapification has to be done, yes? From 5, you agree, yes. When I do heapification, 5 is a parent node. Where is its chain node? Where its chain node exists? It's the leftmost chain node. If it is, if I had one more, it's a complete, you can see. So still I am doing from the left side only. This whole left side it is happening. So now can I run the heapification on 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. What will I get at the end? If I do heapification from bottom to top, it's none other than built heap. If I am doing heapification from bottom to top, that is called built heap. And the output I get here is... that will be a maximum heap tree. So let's look at that with animation. Just I look at your questions once. This is the tree for which I have constructed. This is the values for which the tree is constructed. Now if I start doing heapification from 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, my output should be a max heap. Look at this. I did heapification. Then I did heapification at node 4, then I did heapification at node 3, then at 2 and at 1. What is the final outcome that you could see? Is a max heap, yes or no? In this process, if you see, did I miss any of the node without applying heapification? Did I miss any? That's the reason why we will do heapification, to do heapification, we need to know in which order this tree should be. That was the min tree I converted into max. Don't worry, yeah, you are correct. So in that order, to find the order from the bottom to top, we use a built-in. Is this built-in clear or any confusions? If you have confusions, we will have a discussion. Now we understood the built-in. Actually, if you see heapification is happening between parent and chain. and will be changed in from which parent you should start and go all the way in which direction to the top. Now you have understood that theory? Okay, one second. That is a very good question. On what basis you have choose N by 2? Good. That's a good question, Sangeeta. So I'm discussing. Why was 5 sharp 10 before 4 to 2? Very good question. Two questions, right? Okay, great. Okay, there are two good questions. So let me first try to discuss these two questions which people have said. I missed that question again. I'm sorry, reading it. Why was 5 10 sharp before 4 to 2? Very good question. And then on what basis you have choose N by 2? These are really a very valid questions. Okay, great. Okay, good. First we'll work on N by 2. This is the number of nodes by 2. Close. We'll work on this for a minute. Okay. So whoever asked that question, I would like to appreciate them first. Okay. Just let me appreciate. How many nodes, I expect the person who had asked the question to ask, how many total nodes do I have? How many total nodes do I have? Okay, good. When the total number of nodes is given, can you identify what will be the height of a binary tree? There is a formula to find, identify the height of a binary tree for a given node. You can use a formula. Okay, that's great. Okay, now height of the tree is 4 and it's a complete binary. When in a complete binary tree, when you do N by 2, you always end up for the floor. You always end up the last parental node here. Always. Now if you want to increase this, increase one more node, okay, increase one more node, you will do N by 2, still you will find the parent as 5 only. You do parent as 5 only. Okay? And when you keep on having more number, then your parent value. So that remains true for all the complete binary. For that reason, we have choose N by 2. Okay? I'm clear? Okay, good. Okay, great. So I'll take one example. Okay, great. Okay. I'm just updating this. Let's assume. Okay, I'm sorry. I have disconnected that iPad. So let's say we have got one more node here. One more node here. Okay, this is okay for you now. How many total number is now N? N is equal to what? 12. Okay, apply the formula 12 to the base 2 to the floor. What are you getting? 6. See, you are able to find the first parent node from the bottom to top option which has got a change. Now if you increase one more, how many nodes? Total 13. 13 by 2 is equal to 6.5. Okay, the point is not correct. When you do floor, what is the value? 6. You got every day. Increase one more, you'll find. You'll see. So okay, this is a universal formula to find the parent. Because in binary case, how are you finding the parent of node 2? Can anyone give me the formula? How can you find the parent of a node 2? I think I have told you at the binary N by 2. Correct. So that's what the formula I am using. I think I am clear with that. Now the next question. Okay. Now I am clear why I have used the formula N by 2. N by 2 is the formula that is used to identify the parent node of a node. Okay. Of a chain. Sorry. I should not use the word node. Of a chain. So that's the formula I have used. Now the next question is, according to one of your friends, see, this plus 1, Suresh, you have a really valid question. Sir, I have seen somewhere N by 2 plus 1. See, this plus 1 comes when your array position starts from 0. So that I hope you understood it now. Okay, got it? Don't get caught. Whatever you have seen, that's not an offense. N by 2 plus plus 1 is not a wrong answer because they assume the array size starts with 0. I'll talk about height sensors because that's a particularly different topic. That's why I was not answering that to avoid that ambiguity. Okay. Yeah, abilities. Yes, abilities is none other than weakification running from top to, sorry, bottom to top. Okay. Is this two things clear now? Ability. N is the total size of the array. Yeah. The total size of array is the N. Right? If it is 10, 20, 21, because in each block you are storing one value. Okay. Is this clear or any more questions? Yes, ability, Pawan, yes, you can say ability is equal to that. Okay. Okay. Let me one more question I think that I missed from one of your friend. Very good. The question was, why you have swapped 5-10 not 4-8? Right? This was one question, I guess, right? One question says, why you have swapped 5-10 not 4-8? See, the thing is, at this step, we decide from where we are starting the building. So we have decided from here we are going to do the heapification, right? And the other thing is leftmost child is this. So the order in which my heapification is done, 4, 5, then 3, then 2, then finally by the 1. Got it? All the way to 1. So I hope I'm clear. Okay. Length is none other than height of the tree. Okay. So let me go back to heap sort, right? The last topic of the day. Just we'll finish heap sort here, just 2 minutes. I will not take too much time. Then we'll have the question and answers. Then we can take break and we'll just pause. Then we'll see. Okay. Now let's say this is the following tree, which is max heap according to you. Is this a max heap according to you? Raghavan, I will answer your question. That's, let me finish this. I have took the note of it. Okay. Is this a max heap? Yes, it's a max. Now, to sort it, if I write, let's say, if I write the depth values, okay, what will be the values that I print if I'm going with the breadth printing? 10, 9, 7, 8, 5, 6, 3, 1, 4, 2. Do you agree? If I go with breadth. Yes. You do any other traverser, will I get a sorted? Will I get a sorted element? Do any other traverser, level order. Okay, fine. What is the level order that you get here? Tell me, someone has told level order. No way you are getting, because 1 is in the left subchain, 2 is okay left, but 3 is in the right. So I can't go till I finish all the left. I doesn't even might not move to the right. So any of the three traversers will not work. Either be level order, be in order, post order, and pre order. None of the three traversers will work when you are constructing a max heap or min heap to print the sorted list. Okay. Now its traverser is gone. Now how will you print? How will you give me the position a sorted list? Now let's look in array, how does the sorted list look like first? First let's focus here. Is 10, 9, 7, 8, 5, 6, 3, 1, 4, 2 is what you are seeing in your sorted in your list with the first tree? Do you agree with this tree? This is the list of arrays that you can, or this is the way the elements are stored in arrays. Do you agree with that or no? But this diagram, is this the array? Yes, no. If 10 is kept at in its appropriate position, at least one element is sorted. Do you agree with that? If 10 is kept in its position, and can I say only one element is sorted? Yes or no? Yes. How can I do? Swap the maximum element to the last leaf node. If I do, is this the tree? Look at this, the new tree what we got. Do you agree with for this tree? Yes? Okay. Will this be the tree's new array? This will be the element's position in the new array if I swap between 10 and 2? Yes or no? Yes. Now, if I run the heap sort algorithm, let's say we have got total 10 elements. Let's say we got total 10 elements. If I run the now heap sort algorithm for first 2 ninth element, that is heap build and as well as build heap and heapification, will I get something like this? Something like this? Is my question clear or it's confused? Is my question clear or it's little confused? Because based upon your answer, yes. What I'm saying is, just forget about present. Okay. Just okay. I'm repeating. So I have swapped 2 and 10. Is that clear? I have swapped 2 and 10. At least you are clear between 2 and 10. Good. Great. Once you have swapped between 2 and 10, decrease the size of the array by 1 because you have swapped with 1 element. When you decrease the size of the array, your new array size is 2 to 4. All the elements that are starting from 2 all the way till 4. Yes? Yes or no? If you build heap this, this is the new tree that you are going to get. Forget about 10. 10 a year. Just okay. Assume that 10 is no more. Assume this is this. This is a valley. If this is a binary tree. Can you say this is a binary tree? Now if I run build heap and heapification, will I get this as my output? Forget here 10 also for a minute. Will I get 10? Yes. Now if I swap between 9 and 2, what will be the positions? So 9 will be here, right? 9 will be here instead of 4. Yes. So if I repeat this process again and again, by the time finally I will get my sorted list. So to do that, the formula what I will be using here, see here, I am doing heap sort is I am going to build heap and I am going to run the algorithm from bottom to top, okay, bottom to top, by exchanging the maximum value to the last leaf value and then decreasing the size and running the heapification, again do the build heap. Right, and the time complexity is order of n log n. Okay, you got that? How I did? Okay, I'll explain you step 3. So you understood the concept. You understood the concept of how I'm repeating. Okay, I'll just say you understood the concept. Yes. Okay. Yeah. So now let's talk about it. So just build heap. You understood? You understood build heap? Just individual. Ask you the question. You understood build heap? Okay. Why I'm doing till down to, I'll just explain it a little bit later. You understood exchanging of 1 to a of I is done. What is this exchange you have understood? Which is none other than a of I is this, and we are exchanging the first element. Okay. Don't worry, I'll just explain. This exchange is a of I is the last position and a of 1 is the first element. I'm exchanging between these two. Okay, that is here it is done. Now, after that, what I did, if you clearly observe, the heap size. What was the heap size here? Can anyone say here? What is the heap size? No, heap size. It's 10. Yes, it's 10. Correct. Because the total number of nodes I have is 10. Now, if I reduce node by 1, what is the size of my heap now? 9. Great. If I do the heapification again, the build heap and heapification on all these elements, will I get a max heap again? If I do heapification, I'll just say why 2, that's what I'll just say. If I do heapification for all these 9 elements, build heap and heapification, will I get a max heap? Yes. Okay. If I repeat the same process of swapping, will I get 2 elements in the sorted position? Yes. Now if I repeat all this process again and again, by finally I will get a sorted list of elements. Yes or no? Now the question is, why loop till 2? Okay, that's a pretty important question. No, no. So what happens is, actually if you see, we are building heap from bottom up all the way to element number, assuming this is 1, this is 2. By the time you reach here, this element, the max element here is already max. So you don't need to swap most. So just simply copy their positions. That once this is copied, you will be left out with only 1 element. So there is no more need to done a heap sort at all. Got it? Always a single element is sorted. So just copy. Got it? Now I'll just give you a simple example to understand why it is still true. Let's say my tree has got 2 elements. by sorting, I just left two unsorted elements. I did the heapification, build heap, just one second. I'll just do the heapification, and somehow I ended up at something called 3, 2. That's it. This was my last step somewhere. I was left out with these two nodes. Now, do I have to do anything further after if I remove 3, which element should be kept in its position? 3. Assume 3 is kept in its position. Right? Do I do any heapification here or build heap here? Do you think anything? No. So that's the reason why we run 2. So matlab, till this point I come, by this time all these elements are already kept in their sorted order. Got it? Why it is still 2 or no? 2 is not, this is A of 1 element, this is A of 2. By the time I come to A of 2 element, all these elements would have been in their appropriate position except these 2. And where you have already done the max heap. I did not get the last question just now. See, heapification here, when you are doing heapification, you will do the first element. Okay, very good question here. Divya, your question should be appreciated. Now, one of your friend has a very valid question. Let me answer that also. Okay. I'll just write one. Let's say this is my current key. Now, what steps make this as max heap? That is heapify. Use the word heapification. Till which element you will do this heapification? When you are at A of 1 only, can you do heapification? Yes. When you are at A of 1 only, can you do heapification? If you are at A of 2, can you do heapification anymore here? So that's the reason in heapification process we always go till A of 1. Got that? Okay, in heapification we go always till A of 1, but in heap sort we don't need. Why? Because already we have done heapification here. So my output is 3, 2, and that A of the down is at this point. Right? I don't need any more heapification. I just need to slap. Got it? Okay. So I think I'm clear. Okay, now we'll open the question. Bishwajit, I'm not ignoring, just one second. I read your question. So one of your friend has a very valid question. As we consider n by 2, it should be only order of log n. Very good. But why it is order of n log n? Like time complexity. Yes. Now, what is the time complexity that you have encountered when you are doing heapification? Log n. Okay. When you are doing build heap, what was the time complexity? Bishwajit, when you are doing heapification, it is order of log n. Order of log n. Okay. When you are doing build heap, what was the time complexity that anyone had encountered? Is order of n. I told you there is a proof why it is order of n. Okay. Instead of that, someone should say order of n log n. Someone feels here. Here you will get confused here. Don't worry. Someone at this point say, I feel I am doing heapification, which is taking log n, and it is also being done on all elements. It should be order of log n. There is a proof which proves that build heap is only order of n. Okay. So just the link is given. Just go. Now these two actions, when you are combinedly doing for a build for heap sort, what will be the time complexity? It will be order of log n. Right? Yes. Yeah, this is it. It's because of the theorem involved here. So that takes one whole session, so I did not want to introduce. Okay. Now what is the question? Why order of n? It should be order of n by 2. Shyam, I may not be able to understand your question clearly. Can you just retype the test? No, it's not typo error. It's not typo. Here you are asking, no? Here it's what I am doing is, once I have reduced, I am again running for build heap. Then in while the process of build heap, I am doing heapification on the existing value. Okay, all the way a of 1 is, I mean to say, from the existing list. You can even write it as a of I. It's not much important. Okay. So we'll take a break, then we'll go for question and answer sessions. If time permits, then I'll open a new topic, else we'll stop for the discussion, right? Okay. After the break, can we start the discussion on the midterm exam? Just 5 minutes? Yeah. So give me 5 minutes. So we'll meet at 12:20 and then we'll have the discussion and then we will go ahead. Okay. Yeah, so can we go for the exam based question and answer sessions, or do you want to finish? There are a few questions related to heap sort algorithm. You want me to finish them first and move on? What do you want me to do? Now, practice is not part of the midterm yet. Just to understand, once you have, when you build match heap, always the top element can be used as a priority. So that is a priority key. So there is a concept called finding out the largest element or the most weighted value. That becomes the priority key. Okay. So priority key is not the part of your syllabus. It's just part of the heat sort. Okay. Any other questions do you have? Yes. Okay. So one of the question your friend has, what is heapifying year of one? It says you are going to continue heapification all the way till the first element. That is what it just says. Okay, if we pop out the maximum from, how do it makes, okay, what makes the remaining node a valid heap? Very good question, Karthik. See, okay, so Karthik had a very valid question. Let me draw and explain his question once. Let's say Karthik, according to Karthik, there is a value called 100, which is maximum, and there is a subtree. This is subtree I'm not going to draw. Okay? There is a subtree. Okay. I'm not doing it. According, if I remove this maximum value, I will have two disjoint. These are two disjoint trees. Yes or no? These are two. Where did I go? So they became two disjoint trees, right? If I remove 100 and I have two subtrees, this becomes unjoined. Two disjoint. Why is this just the same? Oh yeah, some of the structural behavior is very weird. I don't know why. Okay. So this, if I remove this 100, it becomes two digits. How to handle this? Can anyone help me how to handle this? If I have to remove 100, how do I can handle this? Any guess? No, Jolly, you have actually found a correct answer, but one simple solution is replace this 100. Okay. Someone wants to remove the maximum value 100 in a heap tree. That is 100. How will you, if I remove directly, I have two disjoint trees, right? Two disjoint trees. To overcome this problem, how should I delete this 100? Correct answer. Just replace with the last leaf value, the leaf node with 100. No max or min. Do not worry about max or min. Okay. So 100, let's take 100. Somewhere you have the leaf, last value as 5. Replace this 5 with 100. 100 to be 5 place. Delete here. If you delete a leaf node, yes, if you delete a leaf node, nothing will happen. Reconstruct your build heap. Reconstruct your build heap and you will again have a max heap. Got it? That's the way how you can do. So I think, Karthik, your question is clear now? Yes, then redesign the build heap. Yes, that's correct. Got it? Now I think you are thinking in the algorithmic way correctly. Now, any more questions? No, the time complexity of deleting the node is 100. Why? Because you are just swapping it 100 to last question and delete. So it is order of one. Reconstruction of the min heap and max heap, it is again order of n. Got it? No? You got it? Why it is order of one is because you just directly moved it. You know where it's located. So there are constant operations. Swapping and deleting are constant operations. So it is order of one. Okay. Arnav, I'll explain the heap sort once again. Just give me 5 minutes. Okay. There are two very good questions. Someone says, why we can't build heap start from root left then right? See, what happens is, if you are doing from root left and right, sometimes the number of iterations becomes so big that the time complexity is order of n squared log n. There is no wrong, you can start from top, but when you do it from top, the issue is, you are actually working on these two elements, and it might create heap on partial tree. Here the heap might fail, again you do, or here heap might fail. So to avoid all these kind of things, we go from bottom. And to recheck again and again, you run the same algorithm n square time, n times to build, n times to verify. It becomes n square log n. Okay. To overcome this, we do from bottom to top. Is that okay? No, you don't need to prepare prior to Q at all. Linked lists are part of the exams, right? So rather, if you do from top to bottom, every time you have to re-verify, again to re-verify, it is n into n. That's why to avoid that, n square log n time complexity, we do n log n, from bottom to top. Got it? So nature is, when you are doing from bottom, always you are giving solution that that lowest tree is heapified. So I go to the complete heapified tree. Okay. Any more questions? One question is again explanation of heap sort. I'll just do that. Don't worry. Okay. So I'll just explain the heap sort and then we will quickly move to the exam related questions. Just 5 minutes. Hash table is a self learn, but I may say that one thing I can say is focus most on the topics that are discussed on the live lectures. You will have somewhere around 20 to 25% questions from the live lecture sessions related topic. 10% can be self-learned topics, right? No, except heap sort, no other sorting algorithms here. No other sorting machine. Only one sorting algorithm, that is heap sort. There are total question numbers varies from 7 to 9. Okay, not more than 10. The maximum number of questions you will have is 9, which can be subparts also. Suresh, go through the textbook and live lectures will help you. Only heap sort. Yes. Sorting algorithms, it's only heap sort. Because you have not covered any other heap sort. Any other sorting algorithms, right? No, amortization is not part of the syllabus here. Most of my questions will be based on either recursion model or you are talking about time complexity can be mostly on. Previously, I have already marked the syllabus with Corman also here. Please refer to the announcements. Pranay, actually, I have worked on your thing. Okay, one last thing before I go to this exam questions. See, I think everyone has seen this master theorem, right? Most of the questions are from master theorem every day, so I made them also ready. Okay. I think this master theorem most of the people have seen. See, the master theorem, the one which we saw in the class, is actually called master theorem for recursive problems. Now, which if we see all the problems, we have said it is in the form of at n by v plus f of n. Then you are using this method. Now, somewhere people would have come across this kind of master theorem. Yeah, you have come across, right? Okay. Have you come across? I'm just saying, either be YouTube or be any place, have you come across this kind of master theorems? So let me close this. Why I'm spending time on this? This one. On this. This kind of equation, at n by b plus log n, some kind of equations you have got through. Right? Those kind of equations are called as divide and conquer kind of problems. For them, you are going to use a different master theorem, which is none other than advanced version of the recursion based master theorem. Just you are getting the question what I am saying. If you see at n by b plus f of n, the one which you have learned in the class can be implemented. If you see a problem like at n by b plus theta with log n, log square n, some kind of these kind of problems, then you have to use advanced, this is class 1, jolly, this what I showed you is the class 1, right? If you find a problem something like a of t n by b plus theta log n, n square log n, One second. Okay, any of these kind of forms, like AT n by b plus n square log n log square n, you have to go through these rules, these set of rules, which are called as advanced master theorem here. Okay, these are called as advanced master theorem, and they are called as divide and conquer master theorem. Okay, so that's what you have to go to them. I will update these PPTs here. I will share these PPTs for the updated master theorem. Okay, so that master theorem will solve your problem when it is a D and D. You don't need a scientific calculator. A simple calculator will work for the mixing. Okay, so please, that's a part of self learning here. Master theorem with divide and conquer based approach is self part of the theorem. Okay, so that's why I have not discussed. Okay, the very important question people have: what is the pass mark for this? There is no fail. Okay, first of all, I would like to announce you, the one who are in exam are considered to be the past candidates. Cool. Anything else? Okay. Someone is sending. Let me see. Okay. Just let me have a look at what the link you have sent. Very good question. So there is a question in quiz. I asked you, what is the depth of a binary search tree? What is the answer? Yes. I have a question for you. What is the depth of binary search tree? See, depth of a tree is equal to, can I say height of a tree? Can I say depth of a tree is equal to height of a tree? So the height of a binary tree is equal to the depth of a binary tree. If you know the height of the binary tree, then the depth of the tree is the same. But depth of the node and height of the node are two different concepts. The depth of a node and height of a node are two different concepts. And height of a tree is equal to depth of the tree. So right, so according to that you will find the answer. So don't worry. Okay. Yes, it's at the root. I said height, depth of the tree is none other than the depth of the root node. No, there are no questions based. See, your mix. Okay, one thing I will say. How many people have gone through the sample question papers that I have shared? How many people? Yeah. What was the level that you are facing is, I think you are facing it as difficult. I think you felt it as difficult, right? The reason why they were difficult, the model papers, these were all the classes that were delivered physically to the students. So I was interacting with the students physically. So we had a lot of time and they were all each session of 2 hours, and we had a decent number of sessions. For you, if you have seen model paper, did you find it as difficult? The model paper, the one which is uploaded in the site. 50%, I will not say 100% difficult, 100%. It was a moderate paper, right? So your papers are also will be moderate, because see, model papers, the one which I shared yesterday for you, those were all delivered or physically, I was there in the class and students. That's why they are more difficult. But my online papers will be 50-50. I will not say that easy, they will be not tough. Okay? So the papers which I have set for you is a moderate kind of paper, 50% easy, 50% tough. So don't worry. That's why I was saying I was not sharing your model papers, because you get tests. No, yesterday I have shared you some Google links. No, that was sample paper. The one that are already in the Takshila are the model papers. Okay. Swapna, AT n by t plus f of n, few of the divide and conquer may not be able to be solved. That's why they have come up with the advanced one here. Okay. Sample papers. I told you, all the sample papers are for the one who are taught directly in the class. So our discussion, with the offline class itself, I spend a lot of time on discussion. If it's online, you can expect for online class only, I spend more time on discussion. So how much I will be spending when it is a live session? I mean, face-to-face session. Okay. Abhinav, we will just finish your thing. No need, here. I am saying you again, Darshini. I told you, you are only heap sort. Why are you getting, even if you skip heap sort also, you will not lose much marks. Very minor marks you will lose. Okay? One important question I wanted to say you is, this is not the advanced gear. Someone has shared, this is the regularity, this is a regular master theorem. But the one you want, all my live lectures, focus areas live lectures. Okay. So the one advanced you have to, okay. I will send the notes for the advanced by today evening. Don't worry. I'll send some sample problem and solve problems based upon the advanced master theorem. Okay. Just give me time till 10 o'clock today. That all I'll take care of. See, to calculate the recursive function, you should use a master theorem or not. No notes. That's what I'll upload today evening. 10:30 ho jayega aaram se. Okay, so I'll send it. Okay. No, recursion function, not calculation of recursion function, because I have not taught you and I will not give you. Simply what all we have discussed in the sessions, you should focus. That's all. Beyond that, please do not ask too many detailed questions. Did I discuss priority queue, Mr. K? If no, no is your answer. No insertion sorting. Okay. No insertion sorting. Partial theory, but most of the theory will be also implementation kind, like logical thinking. Okay? Circular queue, I have asked you to read, right? And again, 2, 4, 1, 7, again you are asking the same question. Except heap sort, there are no other sorting. Pseudocode is not written in any language. If you are asking, can I write pseudocode in Java, then it's a program. Pseudocode is a one that you write in the way which I showed. If you want, you can write pseudocode using Java methods. That's fine. That is okay. This is, you can solve, this is a recursion based problem, Anisha. The one which you have posted is recursion because it's P of n minus 1. Okay. The syllabus of the regular and makeup exams remain the same. Now, depending on question, their pseudocode question will clearly give you a hint, expecting write a pseudocode. You don't need to write pseudocode at all here. You can write it in a simple step-by-step fashion in an English language of understanding. That's fine. Hash weightage is less than 3% or 2%. Praveen, I am not asking to. Okay, so. Okay, so don't worry, Angelina. The one which I have not discussed, just ignore them, like merge sort, insertion sort, okay? Polemi, I understood your question. How to solve the pre-order and in-order for a given is always constructed tree in order and then write the pre-order and post-order, okay? Always, when a question is given, try to construct tree in order, right? If they say the sequence is post-order, then you start constructing from the left to right. That's the way how you have to. See, pseudo, Praveen, I told you, the code you can write in Python, but pseudocode no one writes in Python. You might use the methods of Python as part of your algorithm. That's fine. I told you, you're writing in Java, it's fine. Python, you write, it's fine. Don't worry. Okay? Any other things? Yeah. Okay. Now, two questions. Are you happy with the way I'm delivering, or do you expect me to improve some more? Or improve? Improvement, directly I'm asking. No, okay, fine. If you feel that there is an improvement needed, I would be appreciate your mails for me so that you should enjoy this course here. Ultimate, my goal is every one of my students should enjoy my course. So I just want you to be more learning in the course, because I want you to ask me questions, I want to answer. So I just want you guys to be very interactive with me, drop an email. Okay, I'm sorry I'm replying to a lot of emails very lately, because from last 1 week I was so sick and I had too much work. But your all emails are read here. I'm not skipping them, but I'm delayed. But I will respond back every mail by today evening, because I don't want to keep. Okay, last announcement. We don't have class tomorrow. Anisha, network mere haath mein nahi hai yaar, but it's a valid input, but I'll work on it, right? I'm sorry. So I'm sorry one thing is I'm replying the mails little bit late. So tomorrow there is no class. The reason why I have not kept tomorrow classes, that's the only Sunday you have left out for preparation. So let you guys prepare, okay? Just focus on the topics that we have covered on the live lecture. अरे यार मैं ओपनली बता दे रहा हूँ, तुम लोग फिर लिंक लिस्ट इम्प्लीमेंटेशन देखो एक दो, लाइक व्हेन यू आर लर्निंग दिस स्टैक्स एंड क्यूज, यू जस्ट रीकैप हाउ लिंक लिस्ट इम्प्लीमेंटेशन इज डन फॉर स्टैक, दैट शुड बी ओके. ओके, एनीथिंग एल्स? ओके, लास्ट वन. नो, डेप्थ ऑफ द कंप्लीट बाइनरी विद एन नोट्स ऑफ लॉग एन एंड नॉट लॉग एन प्लस वन. Anisha, this question, can you drop me this question through email so that it will be easy for me to explain? Okay. One last favor I will be doing for the day is, I will send you 20 questions on the master theorem for the new method, the advanced method by the evening, which I have collected from the internet. So I'm not saying I have written them. I'll share with you. If you are having any issues, you can drop me mail till Thursday. Okay, I'll be happy to, because Friday I'm flying. Friday, Saturday, Sunday I'm not available to internet because I'm going to a place called Jharsuguda, which is pretty remote. So till Thursday I'll be answering the questions here. Yeah, notes also I'll upload. That I asked for last time, so this time you may not expect. No, advanced master theorem is needed because I have actually given one question on that. Yes, I'm sorry, but there's a question on that. Okay, I'm sorry. So, but not major. Very important announcement. Yes, actually I realized there was a typo error in one of the questions, which is for 1 mark. I'll also announce this for everyone in the announcement session. Please do attempt that question, okay? Attempt that question so that I can give you marks, okay? But I will say what to be read for that correction. If you answer that, it is most welcome. If not, at least that's an error from my end, so I want the number to be written, okay? So there is one typo error. If you find any typo errors in question paper, you should attempt that question for email. Then add on mark, announcing that. And that's a 1 mark question, don't worry. That's a 1 mark question, that's what I'm openly saying. Okay? So, no. Right? Yeah. Thank. Okay, Vishwajit, I'll honor your icon. Any other things, or I can close the session? No, or an on question. Pavan, wo mail kar do yaar, please mail me that equation, then I can be able to work. Yeah. See, one big question, very good question. See, if I design an area, is it necessary that my answer should be matching with the solution? Don't worry in that sense. Technically, it will match 80%. If not, and if you have done a minor mistake, we will not remove complete marks. Okay, we'll consider for step by step. At match, there can be a solution if the values are repeating the same way. Otherwise, solutions will be different, right? I am supposed to finish heap sort here, but no one is. Okay, so let me just finish the heap sort pseudo code and then we will close the day here, because that was the question which was pending from some time. Okay. No, I have actually a PA team and a pool of faculty who will be part in the evaluation along with me. So Jita, you can use Coreman if you have Goodread also, you can use any book. So that textbook is not a concern here. Keshav, why do you need to drop off, Keshav? You mean you want to leave the session? That's okay, go ahead. Yes, I said no, I will do. By end of the day, you will have sample questions for advanced master theorem, that is for divide and conquer method. Yes. Pawan, you should have searched this topic in Google, but still you are asking me. It means you want me to explain if the height of a binary tree is log n or log n plus 1. That we will discuss later. It's not that important for this session, so I am just kidding. See, Sapna, I told you, the divide and conquer, few problems get solved, ATN by B plus F of n, but not all. That's why to ensure all master divide and conquer can be solved, they have implemented the advanced. Now, Arvind, I have not taken divide and conquer yet because at least I thought you will explore new areas. So because I expect my students to explore new areas, so I thought people would have done. But what it is order of one, I did not. Pranav, just send me an email here. So there was, just me finish this. I think a lot of people, if there is any technical glitch that you faced in the quiz, you answered correct but it is marked as error, please drop me an email with the screenshot, we will work on it here. Okay. Yes. Master theorem by divide and conquer, all the divide and conquer problems will be solved with the advanced one. Okay. Even theory also, it is not something that you have to remember and write here. My theory questions are something that are innovative. For example, I'll just give you one small example. How do you delete a maximum element in maxi? So for this, you can just simply write your answer in fashion that I will be swapping the largest element to the leaf node and then I will be deleting the leaf element, right? In this way, if you write also, we will evaluate it. You don't need to even write pseudocode. If it is a theory also, we will be asking question. Okay, there is one kind of theory question, okay, which is in the old papers because a lot of people are asking theory questions, how we ask. See, if you remember, I have asked one kind of question, how will you implement two stacks in one array? Does this question go as a theoretical or programmatical question or logical question? Can I say you this question? It's a logical way, and this logic can be implemented as program. Now, how will you write this answer? Should I write in theory? Should I write in pseudocode? Don't worry. For these kind of your diagrams also we consider. Like, let's say you say there is an array of size of n. I start inserting the first stack from the beginning. That is, A of I will contain the stack 1. From A of n minus 1, I will be giving stack 2. Just draw a array, put stack 1 input, put stack 2 input. Finish. That also will get full marks left. See, here we are not worried about how much length you have written. No, it's all we read very carefully. So don't worry, the evaluation will be done on your thinking process, right? Anything else? So please write the exam as if you are solving a problem. Do not worry for the marks or anything. Just enjoy the subject, enjoy the sort. Okay. I'm just going to heap sort. Now please do not disturb me. Now Arvind will be very angry on me. He is asking the same question from long time and I'm just not able to take it up. Sorry, just give me a second here. Okay, just let's. Yes, yes, Abhinav, don't worry. Any student of my course who has really attended my class and started reading should be able to score a decent score, yes. Okay? Because, see, I know there are most of the people who are non-seers, that's why I keep my paper 50-50. I'm not saying my paper will be easy or will be tough. It is 50-50. I take, and my paper will be also not lengthy. Okay? So I'll be not available from Friday morning to till your exam over. So till then I'm available. Friday, Saturday, Sunday. Okay? Till then I'm available. Don't worry. Okay, let me finish the binary heap just because one of your friend was asking this question. So those who have done can leave the session. Okay, if you don't have questions, you can leave because I will be spending some time on heap sort because this is a question from one of your friends. Okay, so now let's just stop this heap sort for a minute. Okay, so first I'll ask you some questions. What is sorting according to you? Arranging the elements in an ordered fashion, right? That's what you mean by sorting. Now, till now, the concept that I have learned is only constructing of a heap where the top root element is and largest element, right? That's the case. Okay, let me enlarge it. Yes, okay. Right, this is the case. Yeah, this is the case what you have learned. Now, to make this into an array format, I should arrange 10th element in my last position, 9th at n minus 1, 8th at n minus 2, 7th at so on. So, none of my travel should actually work. The only knowledge I have is how to build heap. When I'm building heap, I use heapification, right? So, what I do is, since my only the max element, if I move it to the last node, its position will be correct. So if I can swap the last element with the leaf, so the largest element with the leaf node, what it will give me? It will give me a tree, binary tree, with one element in its appropriate position, that is the maximum element, right? 10 can be in its maximum position. Do you agree with that statement or not? If I do the swapping between leaf node and the second and the max node, that's the root node, only one element is in its appropriate position. I can do that. The moment I do, the tree, the heap tree becomes just simply a binary tree. Yes, the first step is mandate here. The first step is mandate. So the heap became just simply a binary tree. Now, if I again resort, the sorting purpose is not solved. Now, how I should do is, now, if 10 is in its appropriate position, do I need to sort anything? 10 should be sorted again. Do you think 10 should be sorted? No. Not what I do. But the tree, when I look, 2 is no more a max. 2 is no more. 10 is removed. But I did not disconnect it. 10 is in its position. But the heap size is reduced to n to n minus 1. So I have only 9 elements. By looking at these 9 elements tree, just look at these 9 elements tree, it doesn't say it's a max or a min heap. Right? Now I will apply my built heap function. The moment I am running the built heap function, what all runs is heapification runs, right? So heapification is run, built heap is run from 5, right? 5, 8, 7, 9, all the way till 2. And along with that, heapification is also run. So I will get my 9 as root. It's a max heap. It's a max heap now. Now, if I move 9 to the leaf, what is the leaf element currently? Can anyone say, is it 10 or 2? 10 is see, I can't discard it from the array. I just can reduce. Yes, it's 2. Just swap with 9 with 2. Swap it. Which elements are in its appropriate position? 9 and 10. Is it correct now? Only 2 elements are in its appropriate. If I continue this process, now my heap size, if I run my heap again, how many, what will be my maximum element going to the root. Sorry. Ranjan, you have answered me correct. Now listen to the question again, once again carefully. Once again, see, if consider, let's say this was my tree. Consider this is my tree. Complete. If I run max heap, which element will go to the top? Considering 10 as part of the heap. Just same. If this is my tree, if I run max build heap, which element? 10, right? So you got why I'm reducing the array size? Why I'm reducing the array size every time instead of saying, see, 10 I can't discard and, okay, one more important thing I forgot to recollect you. Heap sort is the in-place sorting or not? Just Google it here. Is a heap sort in-place sorting or not? Is a heap sort in-place sorting or not is my question. Just Google it. Okay. What is in-place? Can anyone? Sorry, I'm suffering with serious cold. It doesn't need an extra memory. Yes, great. Now, extra memory when it doesn't need, I can't use one more array. Arnav, you should listen carefully. Now, if I'm discarding this 10, it means I have to store it in a different array, which I'm not doing. Do you agree with that, Arnav? No? In-place matlab? Yes. That's the reason why I'm not discarding 10. Now, but what I'm doing is, since 10 should not be part of the build heap, I'm reducing the size of the array by minus 1. Got it now? Yes. Now, after this iteration, what will I do? I will reduce it by minus 2, minus 3, so on. Got it. Okay. Now, you got how the heap sort is working? Sorry, accidentally I clicked on mute. Okay. There's a very good question from few of my friends. They say, when you are running build heap, there is a concept of n by 2, correct? There is a concept of n by 2. When I keep n by 2, my n size is what? Okay, sorry. What is my n size here? It was 10, right? Was it 10 or no? Was it 10 or no? If I run n by 2, always my parental node from where my build heap has to run will remain same or no? Will remain same or no? If I am running, that's why to overcome that problem, what we do is, here if you observe clearly, I am reducing the heap size. In first iteration, my heap size was n. In my second iteration, it is n minus 1. Third iteration, it is n minus 2, so on. Got it? That's the reason why we keep on decreasing. Okay. Now, very good question I have got from one. Why did I start 10 to 2 is, in this is a max heap and 10 is to be a sorted list. So, if 10 is in the last in my position, this will be its correct position. That's to make 10 in its appropriate position in array, I did this one. Okay? Any more questions? In every iteration you are doing build heap. See, when you are doing build heap, inside build heap there is heapification. No. So both extra, in every iteration you are doing build heap as well as heapification together. Okay, got it? Right. Chalo yaar, I hope you understood this. Still, are there any questions for you now? Very good question. Darshini, if your number was small, what you do is there is a concept called deletion. You start something called deletion of heap. Okay? So that you should learn. Just give a try. Okay? Deletion of minimal element is a concept. See, heapification is part of the heap sort, build heap here. So that's the reason why that's why you are doing heapification. See, here why I am calling heapification is your question, right? Okay. See, in the built heap, the swapping, whatever you are doing, is just the heapification as the internal part of built heap memory. Okay, that's why I go. If you ignore this also, it's not wrong, but make sure the loop you are taking care. Okay, that's all. Follow me as a very good question. If the floor of n by value is not present, then will it be, what will be the heap? If n by 2 is not at all, it means there is only one value and that value is considered to be heap. Or it can be an empty tree or a tree on a mini or maxi with one node. Right, follow me? Anything else? So, why is the order n log n? Okay, very good. What is the time complexity to run heapification? Log n. What is the time to run built heap? Order of n. In heap sort, you are doing this iteratively. You are running this again and again. That's why it is order of n log n. Okay. So, Darshini, that's what I told you. You have asked me question, if my root is smallest element, what will be the first step that I will be doing? See, the first, if it is a minimal element, it would have been in its appropriate position. It would have been in its appropriate position. So the first element is a sorted list. Now what you should do is remove the first, you will have 2, 3, 4, the next element. Build heap. The one which you are ignoring these values, here you are ignoring the values from the end, you will start ignoring from here. Here it is. Okay, let's take example. This was 1. You wanted this to be the minimum, right? You ignore, construct your binary on from 9, 7, 8 all the way from here. Got it now? Okay, what is A of 1 called? Why A? See, I am saying heapification is done all the way till the first root node. The built heap is done only till this point. That's all. To just give you a, so if you are not, if you just want, you can say heapify. Remove this. Heapify on the array A. That should be okay. If Sam is confusing one, you ignore, you just say heapify on A. That should be okay for you. Yes, Anamika, when you are doing the max heap, when you are doing a max heap, and if you wanted a sorted list, you can always, you have to replace always the root node to the last node. Okay? If the total node is 13, floor of 13 by 2, yes, it's 6. Yes. 6 is not value. Follow me, 6 is not a value. 6 is the position of the element that is stored in index 6 here. Yeah. Okay, whatever value is stored in the index 6 will be considered. Okay. You don't have any chance of getting mini based questions here. Got it? Okay, so I am ending the session. I think you enjoyed learning heap sort. One last and final request for everyone is, see, if time permits, I decided to discuss about something called these three sortings. That is, wait, I'm just, let me finish this and then we can, about insertion, selection and bubble sort, which are not part of our syllabus through. So I request, once you are coming to the next session after the mid, you have to go through insertion, selection and bubble sort, for which I will share you the PPTs. Okay? I'll share you an email asking to prepare and come for the next session. Okay? Okay. Chalo yaar. We have a great day. Wish you all the best. Okay. And if you have any questions and corrections in quiz, please do drop me an email. Even you can do this after your midterm, because spend your Sunday productively on learning for the exam that you are approaching. Happy weekend and happy learning. Chalo.